Please watch until the end. Good day, everyone. So I'm talking about cargo documents prior loading and upon completion of cargo operations. So by the way, I'm here just to emphasize only about the basic or common practices na ginagawa natin sa barko, no? So prior loading kasi upon the arrival of the vessel, kailangan you have to declare in war. Tinatawag nilang notice of readiness. Pag sinabing notice of readiness, ito yung sinasabi nilang na in every respect, kailangan na ready to commence to load na yung barko mo or other is to discharge na may naka-indicate doon kung ilang quantity at saka anong kargamento ang didiscarga in accordance with all terms, conditions, and exemptions of the governing charter party kung kailang date man nagkaroon ng charter party kung kailan na deliver yung barko dun sa charterer. Okay. Upon arrival in the loading port, so kakaroon yan ng tinatawag na cargo inspections kung fit na ba yung cargo holds natin para kargahan ng kargamento. So pag once na pumasa naman yung cargo hold inspections nyo, magkakaroon kayo ng certificate of fitness to load, no? Now prior to load cargo, kailangan ay matanggap mo yung tinatawag nilang cargo shipper declarations, no? Very important yan, including yung sampling moisture report. Kasi itong tinatawag ng cargo shipper declarations, nandoon yung naka-indicate about yung mga transportable limit regarding this, kung anong kargamento meron ka. So, ang mga naka-indicate doon ng mga informations about this cargo shipper declarations, yung katulad ng specifications of anong bulk cargo, no? Stowage factor, angle of repose, no? Trimming procedures, no? Meron din tinatawag na chemical properties if potential hazards na yung kargamento mo basis dun sa class and UN number and blah blah. Meron yung mga number. Then as per the IMDG code, no, or IMSBC code, the International Maritime Solid Bulk Cargos. This group are divided into three groups, no? Group A, Group B, and Group C. While the Group A cargos which may liquefy if shipped at a moisture content in excess of the transportable moisture limit. While the Group B naman, kung tawagin, is cargos which poses a chemical hazard which could give rise to a dangerous situation on a ship, and the Group C cargos which are neither liable to liquefy nor to possess chemical hazards as Group B. In short, wala dun sa kanilang dalawa as a Group C. Okay. And any relevant special properties of the cargo, dapat naka-indicate din yun. Okay. Aside from the cargo shipper declarations, no, there's additional certificates na required. Katulad ng certificate of moisture contents and transportable moisture limit, yan yung nabanggit ko kanina. And weathering certificate also, kung applicable doon sa kargamento mo. Exemption certificate also, the same, if applicable to your cargos. And other specify cargo certificate of moisture and density, kung kinakailangan. So that's all for the prior to receive cargo, no? Cargo shipper declarations, NOR, and hold fitness certificate. Yan ang mga importante. Including all additional required certificates. and of course yung initial draft survey report. And now, let's proceed to cargo documents upon completions. Number one is final draft survey report, no? With the other parties, combined draft surveyors with ship officer and shipper or terminal or coming from charter representative. Upon obtaining of the cargo during the final draft survey, so mag-settle kayo ng final cargo stowage hatch-wise, no? Per holds kung magkano, kung ilan bawat holds ang nilalaman. Okay. Okay, yung pangatlo is SOF, ang tinatawag na statement of facts, no? Ay dapat ay proper recording synchronized as per the vessel's movement during the operations. Kailangan ganun din ang nasa logbook. Okay. Kindly reminder lang, no? Upon signing of statement of facts, you have to extra vigilance when it comes to general remarks, no? So, as a master, so ang re-remarks mo lang naman doon is no delays on ship's account or as per actual cargo intakes basis doon sa final drop survey. Minsan kasi maka-encounter tayo sa ibang puerto na nagkakaroon tayo ng discrepancy ng kargamento between the ship's figure and shore figure kung ilan ay cargo natin on board. Yung pang-apat naman ay katulad ng meat receipt tsaka yung cargo manifest, no? Ay dapat ang quantity ng cargo basis doon sa final draft survey result nyo. Okay. Then number 5, yung tinatawag nilang tally report, no? Importante din yan. Which is performed by the stevedoring company or terminal side. Then yung pang-anim yung tinatawag na authorization to sign bills of lading. Very important yan. One of the purpose of authorization to sign bills of lading is to authorize charterer agent to sign on my behalf the bills of lading covering the cargo according to meet receipt. Basis on my experience, no, never pa ako nakapagdala ng tinatawag na bill of lading, no. Actually, pwede naman bitbitin ang bill of lading ng kapitan. However, ay dapat may clear instructions or writing agreement between the owners and charterers na these documents, kailangan na magbigay sila ng clear instructions na dadalhin ni kapitan. Assuming, no, wala tayong dalang bills of lading upon departure at loading port. Then, prior arrival sa discharging port, dapat ready ng bill of lading. Or otherwise, ay dapat mag-issue ng head owners ng LOI para ma-discharge yung cargo without bill of lading. Okay. And finally, number 7, port clearance. No? Kailangan natin yung port clearance upon arrival to the next discharging port or next port. Okay guys, thank you again for watching this video. So, hoping na na-enlighten kayo doon about sa topics ko. So, ingat na lang po kayo. Good luck and bon voyage always, everybody. Out.